Good morning, student. Here I have brought one new creation, World Folk Paintings. In the first part I will show you in this video, and second part I will show you in the next video. Here I have select African folk art. So first of all, we have to put cello tape all four sides. Then after flatly color the background with a red or saffron color. We have to wait for dry few minutes. Then we can start drawing and coloring together. A student, for this you can apply sketch pen also, but you have to wait, the paper should be dry. Then you can do, if you comfortable, you can do along with the poster color, acrylic color, by theme brush. These are designs we have to create, because pencil will not work on paper properly. But for your comfort zone, you can do by pencil also, first of all the drawing. Then after you can do by color. And you can do one more thing. First of all, you can do by pencil, then you can overlap the pencil by sketch, then you can fill the colors. Student, traditional art describes the most popular and studied form of African art. African folk art, one of the most found forms of art in Western Africa. Here I am just going to do one more figure. And just because of this figure, like in painting, there will be composition. Because African folk art also based on composition, as well as Indian folk art like Worli. It's a little bit similar with the early Worli painting because of the color combination. And basically African folk art based on mother and child relationship. And we can see in African folk art villagers in their tradition. These kind of textile we can create on the cloth. Face color and hair style representing the African style. And of course, dress designs also. By these drawing, by these creations, it's describe, it's explain African folk art. Dress is colorful. I'm doing by brush. You can do these lines by sketches also, but sketches will not be very effective as well as colors, because it's a more contrast and dark. Then I'm just going to fill color, and it's not a compulsory, just you have to fill only this color. You can exchange the colors. And in the dress, mostly they use contrast color. That's why I have select yellow, purple, red, these kind of color we have to, especially they were using these colors in the paintings, all the natural color, and primary secondary colors also they use. Here I'm just doing by purple color. And some paintings of African folk art based on any especially occasion, festivals, they celebrate their festivals. We can see that also. And just like because of the name, we can find the folk art means it's a villagers' art, and that is why African folk art also made by African lady, African villagers. That is why the title is a folk art. This is the speciality of the folk art. And these creations they do on the board, they do on the wall, and some papers also and canvases also they do. After the 19th century, African art finally came into existence because some of the artists they were starting color on the canvas. All these colors we have to feel by thin brush, and by these light colors we show the final touch. And just because of the light colors we can show the beauty, charmness of the paintings. Here I'm just going to remove sellotape from all the four sides. It's almost completed. Children, you also try to make and enjoy African folk art. Thank you.